Okay, hello everyone. Welcome to this presentation about Joomla under the hood. My name is Peter Martin. This presentation will be online afterwards, and all the links are a different color and you can click them. So I hope that everybody of everything can be found later on the internet. So my name is Peter. Besides a Joomla volunteer, I'm also doing a Linux user group because I'm a Linux fanatic. And I organize business meetings, monthly business meetings for entrepreneurs. I'm in Nijmegen, that's here in the east of the Netherlands, just next to the German border. And we have a lot of old buildings because the city is 2000 years old. This one is from 1200 something. We also have new buildings. This is our house. And this is my record rack. I collect records. And this is all German because I came to Germany, and this is Kraftwerk, by the way. My business is located here. I do Joomla support and custom development, like extension building. And besides extensions, I also am a co-founder of Data2EU. Together with Sigrid Gramlinger, we created an online processing index tool. Besides that, we also have a small extension called D2 Content. In this presentation, I will start with object-oriented programming. I will tell something about extensions and then about core functionality in Joomla that is used by all kinds of components. So who in the room is a programmer? Because I can't see the... okay, great. Great. So you probably know what object-oriented programming is. If you already know it, I hope that I can give you now a sort of view how to explain it to people who don't know what object-oriented programming is. So OOP, you have classes, objects and methods. A class is a blueprint what an object can do. An object is an instance of a class, and a method is an action that can be done by an object. Cool? Well, this is a bit difficult, a bit abstract, so I try to do it in a different way. I like baking cake, and if you bake cake, you have a recipe. In this recipe, you have all kinds of ingredients and all kinds of things you have to do, like mixing. Mix butter, mix everything into smooth dough. It doesn't explain how to mix. If you read the recipe, you know what to do. You have to get a mixer. You can have a mixer. The mixer is an object. And it doesn't really matter which kind of mixer you use. You can use this one with your hand, or an electronic one, or maybe a more luxurious one. It doesn't really matter. You put stuff in, and you get stuff out. It doesn't really matter which kind. The inner working, we don't know how it works. I mean, I don't. And you can also reuse these objects. I mean, it's not just for making cake. You can also make other stuff with it. So Joomla works with objects, and Joomla is working with extending those objects. And to explain that, this is a small Hans and Gretel house. In Dutch we say Hans and Grietje. I don't know what's it in German. Yes, okay, Hans and Gretel. Well, my daughter, when she became 7 years old, she wanted to build this house. And she knew that she needed some cake for that, but she doesn't know how to make cake. So her daddy became an object because he asked me, "Daddy, could you make a cake for me? Could you bake it?" And then, okay, I was baking a cake and I was using another object, the mixer. So all these things are using each other and extending each other. And in Joomla, we also have another thing called Model View Controller. We all use it daily, I hope. And when I explain it like this, you have an input, the data, which is in this case on a video recorder. We have a television, which is the view, and we have the controller, which is in this case a remote control. With the remote control, you determine which data you put to which view. And people in this room might see, yeah, this television is too old for this remote control. You're right, it's just a sort of explanation. And if you look at it in a diagram, because of the URL, the route will be determined, and the controller will get data from the model and put it in the view. So now the most important part of this presentation. If you forgot everything else, I don't mind. If you just remember the Joomla runtime, then I'm really happy. So what happens if someone visits your Joomla website? I mean, you immediately get the front end of your website, or maybe another page, but you get a page. And what happens? Well, first of all, your web server will ask for a file called index.php. Your PHP parser will parse the index.php, and then Joomla starts. The first time, the thing that Joomla does in the index.php is it defines jexec, a constant that is set so that all other files that are opened will keep working, because all files of Joomla are protected with defined jexec or die. So if you go in the browser, open a file that has this, it will die. You can't open it, you can't use it. But if Joomla uses it, because the index is loaded, then you can load all the files. So this is the first thing that Joomla does. The second thing that happens during the runtime, Joomla will define the locations. The locations of all the important folders, because it loads defines. Then the third thing, Joomla will load framework.php. That will require some libraries and also the configuration.php. In this case, if you still have the slash installation folder, Joomla will say, you have still your installation folder, we can't continue. And also, if you don't have configuration.php, it will try to start the installation. And also, it sets the error reporting, etc. And then, the last part of index.php is where the execution starts. And here, what you see here is JFactory get application site. This is for the front end of the website. If you go to slash administrator, then it will be administrator, because administrator uses most of the same libraries, but also a couple of other libraries. So then the application, Joomla starts as a sort of application. And the first thing it will do, it will load some classes like the CMS application, the site application, and the factory application. In the backend, it will load the CMS application, the administrator application, and the factory. Then it will initialize some stuff like, okay, is there a session? Because it starts, it tries to load a session. If there is no session, then a new session will be started. If there is a session, the user might be retrieved, because maybe the user has been logged in and you want to get the state of the user. After that, the most important thing now, the plugin event. There is a plugin event, a system event, which is called on after initialize. So after this start, the initialization, all the plugins can be triggered that need to be run at this at this time during the runtime. Now we go to another thing, the route. The route method will determine the option, view, ID, and item ID. The option is used to determine which component should be loaded. And all other things are also needed at later states. And here, another plugin event. So what happens? Joomla calls all the system plugins that have the onAfterRoute method, and it will be used at this place. Now, because we know the component, because the option has been loaded, the component will be dispatched, and the document, the router, and the params are retrieved for this component. And then the component will be rendered on the screen. I mean, it will be rendered. It will not be on the screen yet, but it will be rendered. And we have a plugin event again, the system on after dispatch. So now we get to the rendering phase. The template will be loaded. And in the template, we have also a plugin event before renderer. Then we render the document. So the output of the component will be shown, and the modules will be loaded. After that, we get three more system events: the on after render, on-after compress and on-after respond. The on-after compress is meaning after GSID compression, if you have enabled that. And on-after respond is just after that. So, in short, a visitor visits your website, the index.php get executed. It will define the locations of all the necessary folders. It will load the Joomla framework. It will start the application. It will get the route. And because of the route, it determines which components will be executed. And then it will render the page. And then the visitor will see the result. This all happens under the hood. So, we have extensions in Joomla. We have these extensions, plugins, modules, templates, and languages. Except we have two more, the libraries and the packages. And if I look at components, the things that you need to know about components is they determine what happens in Joomla. I mean, they are loaded and they can have multiple actions. They can have multiple views and they determine what happens on the page. And therefore you can only have one component on the page. The component is loaded in a template by a small thing like JDoc include type as component, and it's possible to override the output. And they are triggered by option.com, the name of the component. So components have model view controller inside. The model is the interface to the database. HTML output is the view, and you can override it by putting it in the HTML folder of your template. And the controller, it defines what to do, the CRUD actions. And display is default if you don't do anything. If I go to plugins, a plugin does one thing in the background. You can have multiple plugins, and they load by the order that they are defined in the Joomla plugin. In the backend, if you look on the plugins, the order is important. So they listen to events. And they are triggered by the plugin helper import plugin. And here it would say system, or if you have your own component, you can create your own component name. And they are triggered. If you trigger them, you can trigger the event, the method. So the methods that are defined in it. So these are the default plugins, but you can write your own plugins if you have your own components. Modules are really simple. While components have different views, models have just one view. They have a single action, and you can have multiple modules on one page. They're also defined in the template where they should be put, and you can override them. And the menu item determines which modules are loaded. The structure is really simple. You have an entry point, an XML file with the installation stuff, and also the parameters. The model has the is in the helper.php. So if you want to retrieve information from the database or other sources, and a view is of course what you see on the page, and you can override it. Templates. They determine the layout of your website. It is HTML plus CSS, and you can have one template on a page. But you can have multiple templates in your website because you can assign them to your menu. Oh, it's really difficult to see. You can create overrides of modules and component output. You just create an HTML folder and a structure. And you can have maybe a PHP and an XML. The XML will be loaded when you want to create a menu item. And you can also add some of your new menu items that you use in your own PHP. Language. The language is for the translation of system labels. You can have one language on a page, but you can have multiple language in your website. You can have a multilingual website. You always have a language label, and in a language files, you put the translation of it, and you can override them. You have the core language files, which are in the folder language ENGB. If you have your own component, I recommend to put the language file in your own component. It's easier to find if you want to change stuff, because it's in your own component that you are creating. And something else, it's easier to find. And if you install your component and you have multiple languages, like maybe you have German, Dutch, English, French, Spanish, and the language of the website is only in German. If you in the future decide to add Spanish to your website, then you already have the language files included. You don't have to install them separately. The overrides are all in one file, and the overrides for the English are in language overrides, ENGB override. Then parts that are often forgotten are the libraries of Joomla. The libraries store a code that you use in multiple stuff. If you have multiple components, you can use a library for things that you use a lot. And if you look in Joomla, you see the libraries vendor PHP mailer. These are external libraries that are used in Joomla. And to keep those up to date, regular users don't have to do anything. But before Joomla, a new version of Joomla is shipped to the end users, people from the project will use Composer to update the packages, because Composer is a really nice dependency management tool to keep packages up to date. It also has an autoloader. So, packages. If you have an extension that has multiple packages, like a component, a couple of modules, maybe a plugin, it's possible to create packages. And with packages, it's more easy for end users to install your stuff. Otherwise, maybe they have to install 5 different zip files, and now they just have one package, which includes all those 5 zip files. So that was basically the Joomla extensions, an overview. Now I would like to discuss some of the core functionality that Joomla has that all components can use. If you write your own components, you can all use this stuff. The first of all, the menu, how menus work. The menus are necessary for the navigation in Joomla, and also to trigger the component views. You can also use the menus to assign modules or templates. You have front-end menus. Bless you. We have front-end menus. And since I think Joomla 3.8 or 3.9, you can create menus in the back-end. And this is really nice. So you can set up your own structure. You can use ACL in Joomla to have other groups, have other back-end. Something what is interesting, they have nested sets for the menu table. Meaning, if you look at the table menu, it has all the menu items, the front end and the back end menu items. The order of those menu items, if you look in the front end of a Joomla website, maybe you have news, and then maybe you have local news, etc. And the order of it is determined by 2 fields, LFT, RGT. When I learned about this, I was, wow, this is really nice, because I have seen these fields in the past, but maybe 6 years ago somebody explained how it worked and a world opened. I found this website. It's from MikeHillier.com, and besides this nice diagram, he has all kinds of SQL queries to determine stuff and to get maybe if you have something, what's a parent or how many children it has. And if you look at this scheme, you can see on the top it says electronics. There is a 1 on the left and 20 on the right. So the LFT is 1 and the RGT is 20. And if you know the LFT and the RGT, you can calculate how many children it has. You do it like this. 20 minus 1 is 19. You always subtract 1 is 18. 18 divided by 2, because you have 2 sides, is 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So you have 9 children. And if you add a new child here, then you have to recalculate all the values, but the child here will become left 4, right 5, and this will become right 6. So this is a nice way to structure data. And it's not only that the menus use this, the categories, the tags, and I think also ACL uses it. So if you have your menu failing in some way, because you try to drag and drop stuff and it doesn't work like you expect, or maybe you have some weird errors on the front end, the best thing you could do is rebuild. Because when you rebuild the menu, the LFT and RGT fields are recalculated, and there is also a field called path, and in path the whole path of the item will be written out. The categories. Categories are really interesting. In the past, we had section and category for Joomla 1.5. And since Joomla 1.6, we only have categories, but nested categories. What I just told about the menus is also here for the categories. The categories are used for grouping data. And there is also a really nice feature called item counter. First of all, the categories itself. There is one category manager that can be used by all components. If you write your own component, don't bother to write a category manager for your own component. Just use the Joomla core. It works like this. If I go to content, articles, you can see here it says categories, and there is the rest of the menu items. The option is com content, meaning this is the com content. But if I click on the categories, it will load the category manager. You still have the same view. It even says articles here. And you can see in the URL that it says com underscore categories. So now the com categories is running the business of the page. It has an ampersand extension is com content. So it knows that com content should be loaded. And what it does, it loads the helper file of com content. And the helper file of com content has a method called add submenu. And it has a submenu that you just saw on the left. And this is also what you can do for your own components. Just add something to trigger com categories. And extension is com, your own component name. And in your own component, you have a helper file. And in the helper file, you do the add submenu. You add your first item, the categories, and then everything else. This is really nice in Joomla. In 2015, I was at the conference and somebody was complaining about missing information. Yes?
Is it possible to have more than one context for categories
in the same component? Good question. I don't know. We have to look into that later. No, the question was, can it have more than one context? I heard it's not possible because it only has one context. I solved it in another way. That is, I had the categories and I just created the first level of categories where I like subcategories for my own component. And in the subcategories, I had the stuff that I wanted to have as filters on the front end. So you can maybe work around a bit. It's not really that nice, but you can work around a bit. So in 2015, I spoke to someone at a conference in Nice, in France, and he was complaining about he was missing information because in 1.5, he knew what all how many published articles he had, how many trashed items he had, and it was not there anymore. I talked with him and I said, well, it's not that hard. Well, it was really hard, but with help from the Joomla community, we've created this in Joomla. And it uses the same principle as what I just showed you with the menus. It has the N extension component, like the categories. And there is a method called count items. In count items, you just count the items for your own component. So you can have this list for your own component as well. The core update functionality of Joomla. Oh, so third-party extensions can use the update mechanism of Joomla, meaning if there is a new version of the software, Joomla will notify you as user that there is a new version. But how does this work? Oh, and before we continue, the Joomla CMS update is not part of this part of the component. I mean, the component is called com installer, and Joomla, the CMS updater, uses com Joomla update.
That was different in the past, and I recently had a request in the international support forum that somebody complained it doesn't work when he wants to install a core update with the extension installer.
The remark, what I just heard, is that in the past you could use Joomla's installer to update Joomla just by uploading a new Joomla version. Yeah, I think it's since 3.7 they changed it, I think.
It has changed, but in the Joomla update they have added an upload and install, so at the end you can do it the same way, you just have to use the Joomla update, not the extension update.
So if you want to install, update Joomla, you can use the Joomla updater, and if the update doesn't recognize that there is a new update, you can manually use the updater of Joomla to upload an update package. Yes, that's correct.
Yeah, and maybe another problem we have often in forums that still there are people who think they can update Joomla in the old handmade way, that they copy up the files.
Yeah.
And then they run, if they remember it, they run the database fixer and run the discover modules and so on. This should be avoided.
Exactly. So I will continue with explain how not the Joomla updater, but how the updater of extensions work. So if you have an extension, your own component or a plugin or whatever, you have an XML manifest which will determine which files and folders have to be copied to the server, which database SQL has to be run to create tables, the language files, and also you have the parameters of your components that are there. And you can have update servers. If you define update servers, you will define a link to an external source where an XML will be published that has all the version information of the component. So this is D2 content. We have a package because we have a component and a module. And what you can see here is there's a version number 102, and it has a download URL where you can find the 102 version. If you have installed our extension on your website and we decide to update to 103, then Joomla will notice, oh, I have 102 on this website. 103 is available, and then you get a notification. And what happens in the background? There is an extensions table which has all the information of your extensions, but there is also an update underscore sites that has the extension developer site. And you have the update underscore sites underscore extensions that links to the extensions. And finally, we have the updates, and the updates table has all the information of the updates that are now available for you. So if you want to know if there are any updates, you go to Extensions, Manage, Update. You better clear the cache first and then try Find Updates. And Joomla will synchronize the updates table. When you know that there is some extension that has a new release, but Joomla doesn't recognize it, you better rebuild your update sites. Because after you rebuild, then the update sites table will be rebuilt. And if you then try again to find new updates, then you might find them. There is one thing here. If you do the rebuilding, then the sites that you have unpublished will be published again. So you have to be careful with that. versioning. So if you have your own components, you can also use versioning. I think it's a really handy function. Sometimes I write an article, like for my Linux user group. I have an article, and for the next meeting, I just copy the article. But before I copy the article, I change the date, I change everything. Then I have to press copy. And sometimes I press save, and then I have to change everything back. But if you have the versioning active, then you can, you can get back, because the versioning, it keeps the previous version in another table. It's in a table UCM history. And what happens? Oh yeah, you have to do switch it on. So in content articles options, switch on the enable versions to yes. And then every time you save, the plugin will know that it should save the current information before it actually saves it. It will put it in the UCM history table as a JSON. So it will be just one long string. ACL is also a nice feature that you could and also should use in your own extensions. If you talk about ACL, then you talk about the authorization of the permitted actions. And it has an assets table, which is also nested. And you have two kinds of ACL. You have the one in the front end. It's a visitor allowed to see an article. And you have the back end, like the viewing access levels. The front end, it's part of, in every table you have access, and that's the viewing access. But what I'm talking about here is the ACL in the back end. You can define what a component can do, and you do it with access.xml. It's a file, an XML file, where you can per group, so you can per component, per category, on the level of article, field, group, or field, you can define what a user group can do. And the actions that are available are these. So admin interface, you can create, delete, etc. If you need your own actions, you can also create your own actions. But in the other part where I will show you now, you have to define it. I mean to read it. These are stored in a rules field. And in the backend, when you have your own extension, you do something like this can do, and then you get the actions. And here, if core edit has been set to OK for this group, then the person that is in the group will be able to edit it. If you create a new kind of type, like remove database or kill website, could be, it's possible. So you create your own kill website action. But in your own component in the backend, you should first check if the person in the group is allowed to kill the website with kill.website or something like that. You can define it yourself. Tags. Who's using tags? Sometimes. Because tags can be really nice. If you look at categories, which I like better, categories are to organize items in a sort of vertical way. So within a component, you have an art. You have categories. But if you if you want to have maybe you have contacts, so people who are in the contacts table, you have content, and maybe you have news feeds and you want to connect those together, then you can use tagging. And then you have a sort of horizontal grouping. There are some difficulties with it. Like I found out there is no language association for tags. So for one website, we were trying to have English, Dutch, and German tips. And when we were using the tags, they were showing all, because you can't say that a tag is a certain language, so it should only be displayed in a certain when a certain language is active. So that's maybe something we can improve in Joomla 4.
It could be shipped around if you give the tag the translation.
Yeah.
Say you use it for our languages and it's
No. I just heard a comment that you can use, of course, language tags that are specific for the language. That's correct. But if you see overview pages, you have all the tags, yeah, even different languages. So yeah, we should improve this. Another nice feature, which is really nice in Joomla, are the custom fields. You can create your own data fields in Joomla in a lot of components. Not everything is already working with custom fields, but if you create your own extension, make sure that it is, because it makes your extension really more powerful. So, to load the custom fields that have been defined in the backend, you should first use JLoader register, then the comfields helper fields.php, then you do the fields helper get fields. In this case, it's for the article, because if you look at the fields, there are three tables. Four tables, you have fields, categories, groups, and values. So items are stored for all your components can store the stuff in it. So you have to make sure that it knows which kind of stuff you want out of it. And then for all the fields, you can just use for each to look at them for each. And at the bottom, I say print R. So I have a display of what I get, and then I can use it in my output. The final thing that you can use in your own components are things related to privacy. Since 3.9, Joomla has the privacy tool suite on board, which is to comply with the GDPR. Just having this on your website doesn't mean that you comply with the GDPR. You have to use it as well. You can do stuff with permissions. You can ask for user to, if they register, to give permission that you use the data for certain things. You can register if people want information about what do you know about them, or maybe you get people who want to be removed from your website. This part of the privacy registers that kind of information. And also, if your component that you write, if the component gets data that has personal data, it's good to use the API of this component, so that your component can tell Joomla, this component uses this, this, and this kind of information. So the component can inform the users about it. So, we're almost there. What I just try to tell you is there are a lot of things in the Joomla core that you can use in your own components. It's our menus, categories, updates, versioning, ACL tags, custom fields, and privacy. I told you something about components, extensions that Joomla has. And finally, and this is the most important, I hope that you, if you ever forget everything, I hope that you remember this. If a Joomla website is visited, first the index.php is executed, then the locations of everything is defined. It will load the framework. It will start the application, and when the application has been started, it will find the route and it will analyze the route. And the option in the route will determine which component will be executed. And then the page will be rendered, and then your visitor has a nice page, hopefully. This is it. Are there any questions? I beg your pardon?
In the URL you describe that there's com content option and parameters and so on, but if I look at the browser, there's a different URL. So what happens?
Yeah, okay. The question is, what happens if the URL is being changed? So if you switch on the Joomla search engine friendly option, then you don't see option is com content, view is article, ID is 15 or something. You don't see it. But under the hood, it's still there. I mean, the com content has a router. The router determines how to build this structure, but also how to get the other way around. So it has the build and it has the other, I forgot. So it will use everything to determine what it is. It's under the hood, it's known that it's option is com content, even that you don't see it in the URL. Okay. Other questions? Okay, thank you for your attention.